Hello and welcome to Money Matters Talks. My name is Amol Paranspe and today I am delighted to present Ms. Aparna Ramchandra as the guest of the month. Aparna Ramchandra is founder director of India's first credit advocacy, credit advisory and credit counseling company Rectify Credit. Aparna has an MA in economics, she is PG in banking and finance and also a certified financial planner. Network 18 has published Aparna's book titled Why is my credit report screwed up? Over to you, Aparna.
Thank you, Amol. Before we get going, I would request all of you to like, follow Money Matters Talks channel and subscribe, hit the bell icon so that you get all the latest updates. And let's get going with today's topic, which is a great pleasure because there are still enough number of people who want to figure out what is a credit report, what really does a credit report talk about. And so today I thought let us start with the basics and let's talk about a credit report. Now in India, unfortunately or fortunately, like photocopy has become Xerox, credit report has become CIBIL report. But actually we have 4 credit bureaus and they are CIBIL, CRIF Highmark, Equifax, Experian. All 4 of them give you credit reports for both individuals and companies. When they began, none of them had scores, but over a period now, because the data has evolved and there is enough that they have been working on the analytics, all the bureaus give you a credit score as far as the individual is concerned. Only CRIF Highmark just now is giving a score for the commercial reports as well. So what is a credit report? So a credit report is a very detailed breakdown of an individual's credit history, which is prepared by a credit bureau. Today, let us try and focus only on the individuals rather than get into the commercial bureau. So credit bureau collects financial information about individuals and then based on this, there is an algo that is applied and then they give you a score. Now when I say financial information, they do not look at your savings account, they do not look at your insurance, they do not look at your assets. The only thing that is pulled out is the debt information. So which means every credit card that you have taken, every loan that you have had so far is what is part of your credit profile. Now, before we get into the other parts, it is very important to remember that you and I can just apply online for our own credit reports, which means when you get on to any of these 4 bureaus, you need to submit your basic details like your PAN, mobile number, email ID and name. PAN is mandatory almost because then the data is easy to fetch and they give you your credit report. And today everything is automated so you get a report right away. So you don't even have to wait for a hard copy. So when you get a credit report, now this report has data like I said about all the loans that you've taken, credit cards that you've had, whether they are ongoing, you have closed them, whether you are not using them anymore, or you have applied for but you've never got it. So this entire part is what is part of your credit report. Now this is what you get. Now see, on the other side what happens is a lender needs to submit data of all the people who have borrowed from him to the credit bureaus. This is mandatory as per under the CICRA Act, which was launched in India in 2004. So today, which means what happens is every lender, which means he can be a bank, it can be an NBFC. Now even all the cooperative banks are slowly getting into this fold. So they are supposed to submit this data on a regular basis, which means once in 30 days, this data needs to be going to the bureau and then the bureau updates this data and your credit report is updated. Correspondingly, when they are submitting data, which means this data never ever gets erased. So there is nobody that can say, I had taken loans and now they are no more, you know, visible, or these loans are not going to be seen anymore in a report. They continue to be there. So like I mentioned before, even the loans that you have repaid in full close them are still part of your credit report. So if there is somebody who's been borrowing, say for the last 30 years, they've been borrowing, they've been repaying, they've been closing loans. So today, if you check their credit report, we've had clients with, you know, 65 pages, 70 pages reports, because they have that kind of a vintage because they have been borrowing. Now, having said that, what I would also like to mention here is a credit report is dynamic, which means what? It gets rectified as you get better, and it also goes down if you start messing up again. So which means if you have been a borrower who's gone through rough times, like recently where all of us, you know, went through some tough times as an economy, few of us couldn't repay, there were cash flow situations, our intentions were good but our cash flows were not supporting us, something like that were to happen, your credit profile takes a beating. But once you start working on it, once you're able to rectify it, it is again good. So the system is dynamic, it can go up, it can again come down. So to summarize, so what it is, I'm trying to tell you is, it is very prudent to have a good credit profile, because a good credit profile not only ensures you good loans at a very competitive rates of interest, it also ensures that you find a good life partner, your insurance proposals get approved. These days, even jobs, before they are hiring you, they are checking your credit profile. So having said that, it is very important and wise of you to maintain a good credit profile. Thank you.
Thank you, Aparna, for these words of wisdom. Friends, good credit profile is necessary and important for employers, insurance companies, marriage bureaus, and also for loan givers. We'll talk about loans in some other video. Thank you.